Hi, I'm Angel. I'm a marketing director working in tech, and I spent the last few weeks playing inside of HubSpot's Marketing Hub. And I'm super, super excited to show you what I've learned. This is How to HubSpot. Our marketing goals are all the same. We want to be able to attract more leads, engage with our customers, personalize the experience for them, and be able to track everything all in one place. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can do all of that and more inside of HubSpot's Marketing Hub. By the way, it's completely free to get started with HubSpot's Marketing Hub, so if you want to follow along, you can check out the link in the description box below. Everything to do with marketing always starts with the customer. That's why the Marketing Hub is built on top of the SmartCRM system. This is your centralized customer database where you can start to understand who's opted in, who's converted on your forms, and how long they've been a customer for. This is also where you can create segmentations and lists so that you can get super specific with your marketing communications. To do that, all you have to do is go into the side nav under CRM, click Lists, and then we will create a new list. And then you'll be able to filter by specific customer data. HubSpot actually gives you tons of different ways to filter, such as by contact, by cart, by company, by deal. But wait, let's rewind. How do we actually bring in these customers? There are a couple of different tools that you can use. The first one is Forms. So if you go under Marketing, you can click into Forms. Under Forms, you can create embedded forms, which live on your website organically, or you can use standalone pages, which act like landing pages with forms on them. If you want to create pop-ups, banners, slide-ins, or embedded call to actions, you can go to the call to actions tool, which is right under the forms tool. Both the forms tool and the call to action tool gives you tons of pre-made templates that you can choose from. What's also really cool about the call to actions tool is that it gives you a ton of different targeting options, which means you can reach your customer no matter what part of the customer journey they're in. So whether you want to trigger it by button click, by page scroll, or after an elapsed time, you have all of those options there. Once the customers are in, it's time to turn them into raving fans. There's a bunch of different tools that you can use to do this, so I'm gonna demonstrate a couple so you can see how easy it is to use. Let's start with ads, a great way to stay top of mind with your customers. To find ads, you can go under the Marketing tab and then the Ads tab. If it's your first time connecting your ad accounts, HubSpot has this super easy to use step-by-step onboarding process that will help you through it. But once you have your ad accounts connected, you'll be able to see all of your existing ads as well as their metrics all in this dashboard. When you're creating an ad, of course, the first thing you want to start with is your audience. The audiences feature leverages the customer data that you've collected into your SmartCRM system, letting you target the customers at different points of the journey. When you're creating an audience, you have the options to segment them via website visitors, contact list, company list, or even lookalike audiences. Once you have your audience, we can start creating our ad campaign. There are a bunch of different ad types that you can choose from, but let's walk through how to create a search ad. When you're on the screen, you can decide whether you want to create a new ad or add to one of your existing ads. Today, we're going to go through the new ad. Just like with all of their other tools, HubSpot has AI built in so that you never have to worry about not being able to think of a headline or a description. To use the AI assistant, you just have to click the button, type in a prompt that works for your ad, and then it's automatically going to generate the headline as well as the description for you. HubSpot actually breaks down all the different parts of your ad campaign so that it makes it really easy for you to set up your settings. So if you want to set up your keywords, there is the Keywords tab, the Targeting tab makes sure that you are reaching the right audience. The Budget and Schedule tool makes sure that you are not overspending. And they have an Automations tab, which allows you to decide what you want to do after your ad campaign. So once your customers have converted or have engaged with your ad, you can send them an email or even tag them into an audience. When your ads are up and running, it's time to analyze them with the Analyze tab. The Analyze tab gives you a really great overview on how your ads are doing as a whole. Because we don't have any live ads running right now, a lot of the numbers are going to show up as zeros. However, I still wanted to show you how the dashboard is going to provide all of the key metrics, such as your impressions, clicks, and ad spend. Another really important tool for connecting with your customers is the emails tool. So you can also find that under the Marketing tab. The first section shows you all of your existing emails, whether they are drafts, scheduled, or sent. The flow of creating an email is going to be really similar. You click Create Email, and then you'll be presented with the three different email types that you have. So you have regular emails, which are your single send emails, your automated emails, which typically fit within a workflow, and then your blog emails, which go out after you publish a blog post. Let's go through a regular email. HubSpot provides you with a ton of different pre-made templates, all with different goals in mind. Let's start with a welcome email because that's what you're going to need after your ads. The email editor is a WYSIWYG editor, AKA what you see is what you get, meaning it's a super easy to use drag and drop system. To edit the email, you just have to click into the section you want to edit. So for example, the company logo. If I want to replace the logo, I just have to hit replace and select the image that I want. There's also going to be a bunch of different options for you to play with in the side nav. One of my favorite features has to be HubSpot's built-in AI assistant. To utilize the AI assistant, you just have to highlight the text you want to change and then click the little star icon. You're going to be presented with a couple of different options. So you can rewrite it, expand it, shorten it, or you can even change the tone, which gets pretty fun. Let's say I want to change the tone to something a little more heartfelt. The AI assistant will start to generate different options. And if you like the option, all you have to do is hit insert and it'll replace the email for you. Another tool that I think is really valuable is the personalize feature. This feature allows you to personalize your email so that you are targeting specific customers. To do this, just click the personalize link. Then you can choose exactly what data you want to pull from. So I'm going to pull from the contact data. Then I want to type in their first name. And then you always want to include a fallback value just in case their first name isn't there. Click insert and there you have it. It'll insert the customer's first name. Your email campaigns are up and running. What's next? Well, we want to dive into the analytics. The Analyze tab gives you a holistic glance at how this marketing channel is doing, meaning it's a really great comparative tool to see whether it's driving traffic and conversions in your overall marketing flow. The Health tab, however, looks at your email marketing channel from an optimization standpoint. So what does that really mean? Well, every email service provider has a health standing, which dictates whether or not the email actually lands in your customer's email inbox. As you send emails, HubSpot will provide personalized recommendations. This will help optimize your email health standing. If you want to further connect with your customers, you can use the SMS tool, but just remember that it is a Pro Plus feature. You couldn't have a marketing plan without social media. The social media tool is going to share a very similar layout to all the other tools. So you'll be able to see all of your social posts, write them, schedule them, see them in a content calendar. And of course, all the analytics will be in the Analyze tab. So those are all the key features of the HubSpot Marketing Hub that honestly makes marketing so much easier. You can bring in customers using forms and call to actions, and then you can segment them using the SmartCRM tool. You can engage with them through ads, emails, socials, and texts, and even personalize the experience by leveraging the customer data that they've provided and using the AI tools to alter the tone and imagery. I hope this video was helpful. And once again, I'm Angel. And if you want to learn about any of the other features, make sure to leave a comment down below. If you want to get HubSpot's free marketing tool, you can find it in the link below. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.